What's going on, creative family? It's Dustin Valkema. Guys, today we are picking up where we left off on the last video, which is basically about painting out distractions and fixing seamless backdrops when you guys are shooting wide for a small backdrop, small spaces, and you have all of those crazy distractions, and how to not overthink that process and just get rid of it. Now, in this video, this is all about making your images pop in Lightroom Classic. So we're taking this photo of Rhino cosplay, and we're just going to finish it up so that you guys can see how I went through 250 of these cosplay edits in a week. And I had some really nice kind of smooth, clean deliverables that the clients all enjoyed. So make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I will see you guys in Lightroom. All right, guys, here we are in Lightroom, ready to make this image pop. So the first thing that we're going to do is a base setup for every single one of our photos so that we can create a preset with that, and then we can apply that to every single one of the images, and then we'll go through and add our local adjustments later. So first things first, moved into my graduated filters. So that's either M on your keyboard, or you can click this graduated filter icon. In this case here, we're planning on just dropping the exposure, so we can drop that there and drag from the bottom of our image up. Maybe drop the exposure a little bit more. And essentially all I'm doing here is just looking for a cool way that I can really focus the attention a little bit more on the torso and face here of our subject. So got two graduated filters there. I can make one here come from the left side in, and then we can raise our exposure on that side. Maybe rotate that a little bit more here, come up from the top. Let me drop the highlights just a little bit there so that the hand's not getting hit too hard with that. So at this point, we'll call it done with our graduated filters. We can go ahead and click done, and then we can move down to the rest of the image here. So in most cases, I like to bring my shadows up just a little bit there, and then blacks, I'll bring those down some. Highlights really doesn't matter as an overall preset to use, because that might actually change depending on the cosplayer or your subject when you're creating a preset. Like, I usually like to keep as much of this fairly generic. Like, I generally raise my shadows, I generally drop my blacks just a little bit to kind of even that out. But now we could move on. So from the basic panel, we can close that there. The tone curve, this is one of those things for me that if I really wanted to, I could go in and I could create just a nice S curve here, but I typically didn't, in this specific case, want to use any of these tone curves because I didn't feel like going back to adjust those later. So we can go ahead and delete these points here. And moving right along to the hue, saturation, and luminance. So this is actually something here specifically for Spider-Man that I adjusted, and we can bring those reds. And we can change the hue to a little bit more on the red side here. Saturation, we can pump that up a little bit. And saturation of our blues there for the legs. And then luminance for the red is something that I did play with. So I can pull that up slightly. Need to be too far. At this point, we can go ahead and close our hue, saturation, and luminance tab. And we can head into split toning. So split toning is nice because you can add colors to your highlights or your shadows. Now, most often on this type of work here, I don't like to add anything to my highlights, and I will strictly go into the shadows here, and we can add just a little bit of color, and then we can go through whatever type of color we want. So in most cases, I generally like to go through and make it complementary to the color of my subject. Now, in this case, you know, it's do you go red or do you do blue, you know, whatever the case. And so I would maybe just take this down a little bit, and instead of having just a gray backdrop, I can add just a little bit of color there. And we'll stick with blue here a little bit so that those reds pop out nicely. In detail for me, sharpening, it's one of those things that I may put this up to about, we'll say 50, and we can start there. I don't really like to sharpen my images too much at this point, because a lot of times I'll go through and I can add that sharpening in with my local adjustments that we'll do here in a minute. For the noise reduction, I mean, I don't really need them for this image here. If we did need noise reduction, we could add that. Head down to effects. And one thing that I do to all of my images, whether it's clean studio shots, regardless of what it is, 90% of the time I will go in and I will add some kind of grain, generally between the 20 and 30 range. Now, that does one of two different things for, you know, for the style that I like to have. I really like a lot of cinematic looks, which will have grain anyways. But then it also helps you deal with banding when you get to compression for social media and whatnot. Now, at this point here, we can start working with our local adjustments. And so you can press K on your keyboard, or you can head right up here to your adjustment brush. And that's really going to give you the control over working with things like sharpening or clarity texture adjustments locally. So for me, I just use my bracket keys here, left and right bracket, and that will make your brush smaller or larger. We can go ahead and click right into these presets here and select clarity. Now, clarity is really just adding contrast to your midtones, so that's helping a lot of the midtone details out. So if I go here and undo that, hopefully you guys can see this on the screen here. This is really just going to go through and it's going to make all those fine details pop. And texture is really adding, it's really just emphasizing the medium textures that you have in your image. So you have, you know, if you're familiar with frequency separation, a median between your low frequency color and your high frequency texture or details, this is really just giving like that in-between texture. And so what we'll do is go through here and we can paint. And this is just with a clarity brush. Make sure that we hit most of our subject there. And then we can take this texture slider and we can slide that up as well. And then immediately, because it's really influencing those medium details, we're able to go through and get some kind of a sharper look to the image. And this is why I don't like to work with sharpening too much if I don't have to. And that's because once you start to get, you know, get into painting all of these different brushes, you get way out of hand. If I were to slide down here into my details tab and I were to crank up my sharpening, you can start to get all kinds of things like moire and other artifacts that you may not really want in your images. So at this point here, we have done clarity adjustment and texture adjustment. Now we can create a new version of that brush, and let's say we can do an exposure. So for me, what I generally like to do on an image like this that's already contrasting, I can just go ahead and bring my exposure up a little bit, and then the parts of my model or my subject that are already getting hit by light, I may just go through and paint that in just to emphasize that a little bit. So that would generally happen here on the legs, really anywhere that the light's hitting it. Now, this is kind of similar to a macro dodge and burn or contouring, if you're familiar with those methods. And that's just something that I'll go through here and make sure to hit every area that's kind of getting hit by highlights on my subject. So we'll get the chest here, get the abdomen, just go here and really just kind of make this guy pop. So at this point, if we press our backslash key, that is going to give us our before and our after. You can see here that we're already getting quite a nice look. So one thing that I do realize is that I'm getting a lot of kind of a wash here on the reds. And so I can go click done and head right back into my hue, saturation, and luminance. And then I can just even this red out and completely take those adjustments away, period. We can say, all right, so we can saturate that a little bit more. That's fine. We'll go to like a 35 in that range. And then the oranges here are where the highlights are actually hitting. So we can go ahead and saturate the oranges just a little bit there. But you don't want to go too far because then you start to get clipped colors and that can get really weird fast. In this case, we can bring down, head back up to our basic panel, and we can bring down our vibrance a little bit and see if that's doing anything for us. So in this specific case, I really didn't want to desaturate the colors too far. And so I may just take that vibrance down just a little bit So what that's doing is taking the most saturated values that's in our scene and then just bringing those down to neutralize them a little bit. So if you bring this vibrance all the way down, you're still not going to completely desaturate your image. And same thing, if you bring it all the way up, you're not going to completely oversaturate your entire image. Whereas if I were to grab my saturation slider and drop it, you go to a black and white image, or you can go all the way up to a completely clipped version of chaos. So at this point here, we can go ahead and just drop this vibrance down to, we'll say, a -3, and then we can leave it right here. Now, this is the point here that I hit, and I knew that I wanted one more graduated filter down here at the bottom. And so I click this bottom one, and then you can right click the little handle here and say duplicate. And that's going to allow you to just create that adjustment and then just move it around wherever you'd like it to happen. So at this point here, it's just a matter of tweaking. Some things you may want darker, some things you may want lighter. It's really all up to your personal preference. Now, once you're done with your final tweaks like this, it's time to really put this into a manner that we can use to move past or move through a mass volume of photos. And so I do that with presets for any of my adjustments that I knew that were very specific adjustments. Say like my brushes, we can go ahead and do this one here. And if we go in and we grab our clarity brush that we used, we can just select that and I can head down to custom and I can save current settings, and we will just name that, let's see, texture bump. So that now whenever I want to replicate that specific adjustment, which is what I did on all the whole collection of these photos, I can just go ahead here and create a new one. Now if I go to texture and just switch it, you'll see that we have a texture bump brush here at the bottom, and that's going to give us the same clarity and texture adjustments that we had before. So to create a preset of the overall look here that we want to use across our volume of photos, we can just press Control or Command, Shift and N, and that will bring our new develop preset dialog box. We can just name this Cosplay, go ahead and check all, which will basically just take all of these adjustments and apply them, and we can say create. So now if we head down into our camera roll here, we can right click on this thumbnail and go to create virtual copy. So in this virtual copy, we can go ahead and reset that. We can press tab to open up our other left-hand panel here that will have our presets, navigator, and snapshots. We can head into DV 2019, and then we'll see that we have Cosplay here. So this is what I used to make sure that every single one of my photos had similar adjustments. And then the only thing that I had left to do was just go in and paint all of those local adjustments again. But because I used them on these adjustment brushes and I stored my presets, so for this one here, we're using the texture bump that we had just created, I can go through here fairly quickly and I can paint in all my clarity and just kind of scribble it in there. And sometimes you don't have to be so detailed with it, sometimes you do, but in my case, I just went through and I painted that one in, I went to exposure, and then, I forgot to create a new one, so we can head back down to texture bump. We can go ahead and create a new brush and then switch that to exposure, and then I can go through and I can paint all of those highlights right back over my subject that I wanted. So this was the process that I used really to go through and make everything happen the way that it did. Luckily, it was a fairly smooth process that I was able to complete in time. But that's the gist of it, guys. This is how I went through 250 photos in a week and was able to deliver something to my clients that they really enjoyed and had a lot of fun with. All right, guys, so that wraps up this tutorial on making your images pop in Lightroom Classic. So this is the end of the process. This is what I did to go through 250 photos in a week. And combined, I mean, once you get rolling and you create your presets and you get that look down, it's easy to replicate that. So with the action that we used in the first video, And then combined with the process here, like I was able to work on these images and spend a maximum of 10 minutes per photo. And that some of them were group shots, some of them were a little bit complex. And having this fast workflow really allowed me to spend a little bit of extra time on those ones that needed it, rather than, you know, spending 45 minutes to an hour on every single individual photo, which is something that if you're like me and you're doing it yourself, you can't do. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this. All right. Make sure to follow my community posts. I'll be starting a post on there a little bit more often, looking for feedback from you guys, whether it's on new content, what you guys need help with. That's the biggest thing. If you guys are on my channel and you're not finding what you need, just go ahead and subscribe. Like, subscribe to it. Let me know in the comments. I don't care if you comment on every single one of my videos. Let me know what you guys need so that I can know how to provide the best value to you guys watching. So until next time, guys, create more, say less, and stay creative. I'll see you in a bit.